Hello, my name is Dr. Lavanya, consultant pediatrician in A4 Hospital. Today I'm going to talk to you about the challenges that a mother can have during breastfeeding. So breastfeeding is a wonderful experience for both the mother and baby, but they can have challenges during the first few weeks of life when the mother and baby are adjusting to each other. The baby is learning to feed and mother is learning to hold the baby in the right way for feeding the baby. So some of the challenges that the mother and baby can have is, one, the mother can have a severe cracked or sore nipple. She can have severe pain around the nipple area during breastfeeding. This usually occurs when the mother has not carry the baby well. The baby is not latching well on the mother's breast. So this, when the latching position is right, the mother will not have a sore nipple. So if the mother then has a sore nipple, what do we do? What is the treatment for this? The best treatment for this is, one, to make first the latching position to be normal. Once the latching becomes normal, this pain goes away automatically. Apart from that, there are ointments that can be applied on the nipple when the mother is having a severe sore nipple, but it has to be cleaned before the mother starts breastfeeding the baby in that breast. The mother can also apply the last part of the breast milk on the nipple to help the nipple heal. The second problem that the mother can have during breastfeeding is that she might feel that her breast milk is not adequate, that she's not, the baby is requiring more milk and her milk is not adequate at all. So how do we know that the baby is getting adequate milk? This is based on the amount of urine that a baby passes. Normally a baby passes about 6 to 7 times urine per day if the baby gets adequate milk. And stools, it can pass at least once a day. Stools, and there will be a gradual increase in weight gain for the baby if the milk that the baby is getting is adequate. First 10 days of life, normally there's some weight loss in babies, and subsequently there will be adequate weight gain. So even then, if the mother is feeling that her milk supply is less, what else can we do to help her in getting adequate milk is to make the mother frequently breastfeed the baby. So why do we want the mother to frequently breastfeed the baby is, as the baby keeps latching on the mother, these hormones from the brain start secreting. The hormones called as prolactin and oxytocin. One helps in milk production and one helps in the expression of milk out of the breast. So both of them start getting secreted more. And so this stimulates more milk production in the mother. So she will get more milk supply. So the more the baby sucks, the more the chances that the mother will get more milk. So another way that this can also be done is by the mother expressing milk frequently when the baby is not feeding. So this expression of milk from the mother can be done manually using her fingers or with the help of a breast pump. Apart from this, the mother can also keep the baby skin to skin contact with her. This also gives a happy, pleasant feeling in the mother, and this also increases the secretion of the hormones in the brain, further increasing breast milk production. Third problem that a mother can have during challenge that she can have during breastfeeding is breast engorgement. So what is breast engorgement? The mother has lots of milk in her breast, so it is not, the baby has not taken sufficient milk out of the breast, and the mother is having so much that her breast is fully is quite full, and she might even have some discomfort or pain due to that. So why does this breast engorgement occur? One, again, is when the position of feeding is not right. When the baby is not latching well, the mother is not holding the baby rightly for breastfeeding. Or if the mother is having large amounts of milk production, then also the breast can get engorged. Or if there is long gaps, so if there's a 4 to 5 hour gap between each breastfeeding, then also the breast can get engorged. So how do we help the mother during this breast engorgement would be frequent feeding. So baby should frequently feed, at least maybe 2 to 3 hours a gap. The baby should frequently feed. Apart from that, if the mother still has engorged breast, she can express the milk. If there is discomfort due to the breast engorgement, she can take some medications like paracetamol or ibuprofen to relieve her pain. And sometimes when the mother's breast is very much engorged, the baby will not latch to feed, because what happens is the breast is expanded quite much that the nipple gets flattened. So what the mother can do then is she can initially manually express the breast milk in a palade or a container, and subsequently as the nipple gets straightened, she can continue direct breastfeeding.